you guys. So today, David and I are going to return or mail his old phone back because he just got, what phone did you get?
S10.
Do you like it?
It's not bad. It's not, some nice quality of life features.
Battery lasts quite a bit longer. That's good. He does like it. He's been playing it a lot. He's got a game that he plays that eats like his battery a lot. And I guess this one lasts all day long. So like by the end of the day, he's like, I have 17%. This is fantastic. And normally his other phone would be like dead.
Three times over.
He leaves his other phone, the one that we're mailing, FedEx. That we're mailing back, he charges it all the time and it's always dying. I'm also very, I think I'm coming down to something. I'm very stuffy, my nose keeps running. I probably sound really sick and congested, so that's been really crappy. So that's not been fun. I woke up like this and I'm not super happy about it, and then I have to go to work tomorrow, of course, which is gonna be terrible. So we are also gonna go up to Micro Center and I am going to get a new graphics card for my computer, because the one that I have is an NVIDIA, I think 970. It's from my little brother. He's been letting me borrow it in my computer. We will do a computer tour at a later date so you guys can see the dope computer that my little brother and David helped me build. Obviously, I'm gonna need their help to tell you everything that's in the computer, because I don't know enough about computers to be able to tell you about it myself. But that'll be for another video at a later date. So we're gonna go get me a new graphics card. I'm really, really excited about it. It should be really cool. So the one that we're going to get isn't super crazy expensive. So, yeah, I'm really excited. So, until then. Here we are, we're at the UPS store. David's gonna go in and go mail his, phone back. So we are gonna wait in the car. Everybody, David and I are getting food, which I'm super ready for, and I'm super, super hungry. I had told him that I wanted to go to this place called Ni Hao Fresh, because we've been a couple of times and I really, really, really like it. And I guess on his own accord, he decided to drive us out here, and that's what we're getting for lunch, and I'm super excited. So they have two different bowls. I can't remember the names of them, but they basically have a stir-fry bowl and they basically have a sushi bowl. Obviously I get the sushi one because I really, really like sushi. Shushish. How do we say it?
Sushi.
Sushi. So it's got like sticky rice, and you can get like all the stuff that goes into a like sushi roll, and it's really, really, really good, and I like it a lot. So yay! Dun, 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 dun. All right, guys. So it is 94 degrees outside. It's really, really warm in the car, because you know we were out of the car for like 2.3 seconds. So you know now naturally it's like 10 billion degrees in the car. I mean, because that only makes sense. So I had food from Ni Hao Fresh, which I've had a few times. If I'm pronouncing that wrong, then you know I'm sure I'll be crucified, but it's fine. David got pizza from, what is it, Toppers?
Toppers.
So what did you think?
Oh, fucking delicious.
He got cheese stick breadsticks, and what was that, pepperoni and chicken. We normally always get light sauce on our pizza, because I'm not a big, like, marinara person, personally, and he doesn't like it that much either, so we always get light sauce on all the pizzas we always get, but you actually liked the sauce, didn't you?
It was actually pretty good. It was a homemade tomato sauce, and it was delicious.
You can't see it, but he's talking with his hand. Very Italian.
Making fun of my roots.
You're not Italian. He's Brazilian. He was born in Brazil. He's actually from, go ahead and say where you're from, because I can't, I don't want to butcher it if I pronounce it.
Brazil. You're welcome.
I meant this
She can't
city.
Pronounce that well. I don't really know why.
I mean this city. Rio? Rio de Janeiro?
What was it?
You say it.
What was it?
Rio de Janeiro.
Mm, that was good.
How do you pronounce it?
I mean, however you want me to.
The proper way. Let's hear it.
Rio de Janeiro.
Oh, that sounded way better than what I said. I like that way better. Word the wise. Date a foreign man. They're sexy. I'm just saying.
As she shows my double chin.
That's not true.
You like all my voluptuous curves?
like there's a place down here on the plaza that's, we'll probably insert like a photo here of like the sign or whatever so you can see the spelling of it, but everybody pronounces it Fogo de Chao. David pronounces it differently, so I try to pronounce it the way that he pronounces it. David, how do you pronounce the way people say Fogo de Chao?
Fogo de Chão.
Which is not obviously the same. So when people say it, I say it the way that he taught me to say it, which probably isn't 100% correct, but it's better than what everybody else says that I feel. And I feel slightly less ignorant saying it properly because he speaks Portuguese. So I'm trying to do him a little bit of justice. So especially because I've been to Brazil, because he took me last year to go visit his mommy and his grandma, which was an amazing trip, and we had a lot of fun, and we got to go see the Jesus statue, and we got to ride, what is it, the Sugarloaf cable cars, and the view is
Sugarloaf.
What?
Sugarloaf.
Sugarloaf? Oh, Sugarloaf.
Like red loaf, yeah.
Oh, I thought it was love this whole time.
Sugarloaf.
Oh, well now I feel like an idiot. Okay, that's good times. Sugarloaf cable cars, why is it pronounced that way? That just sounds stupid.
Wow.
I like Sugarloaf better. It sounds sweeter. Ha! Sugarloaf. Yep, sweet.
There's the door.
I'll go home. But we'll have to do maybe a video of a recap of our trip to Brazil. I was supposed to actually put all those pictures together and send them to his mom like a year ago. And I still haven't done that because I'm lazy, and when things go on SD cards, they usually stay there.
She disowned you as a daughter-in-law.
I seriously doubt she's disowned me.
She really did. She told me. You made her sad.
Well, I'll send her the pictures, and I'll make a video, hopefully, of our trip to Brazil, because it was really amazing, and it's the first time I've ever been out of the United States. So it was a really good trip. We had a lot of fun, a really good time, and the view is so spectacular. The only crappy thing is the one day that we visited the Jesus statue, it was really cloudy. So we had to like hurry up and get up there, which I think you could have, what was it, an elevator or something to get up there? Or we had to walk. I think we had to walk. It was all stairs.
We took a little train.
We took a train, but like we did walk the rest of the way up, which was still quite a bit of stairs. I mean, like it could have been worse.
It wasn't that bad, but when you're like fat and double chinned and out of shape, then like it was rough, man. It was a rough life. For us chunky people.
chunky. But it was a lot of fun. The view was amazing. We took a lot of really
good shots.
Side note,
I've never watched The View, so I don't know if it's actually amazing or not.
We are not talking about the talk show.
You just said The View like 7 times.
No, The View from the Jesus statue.
I never knew.
The View out over
I
Brazil.
I never knew that the people from The View went out to the Jesus statue and they had an episode on that.
I can't talk to you anymore. I can't. I'm done. Anyways, so that was a really good trip. We had a lot of fun. Maybe at some point we'll put together like a video for you guys so you can see some of the pictures that we took and the trip that we had, because it was really, really amazing. Kind of a once in a lifetime kind of thing. It is not the safest place in the world, so I don't recommend going by yourself. Especially if you don't know like the language, because they definitely tried to screw us over money-wise when we tried to do an exchange. I think at one point David tried to do like $100 in currency from our money to their money. And then they tried to give him like 100 what euro rios, that's what it is. I sound like a doofus already. Which 100 rios is equivalent to how much US cash?
Right now, like 23 bucks.
So yeah, they were really, really trying to screw us over. So you just have to be super careful. I mean, think logically, like if you're switching out 100 US dollars, like it's not gonna be 100 whatever wherever you're going. You definitely do some homework, because literally the US dollar changes the amount that it's worth constantly. So you just use some common sense when you're traveling abroad, when you're doing exchange, because it doesn't really matter where you go. I think they're gonna try to steal your money either way. So just like be super, super careful. And if you can go with somebody that speaks the language or is from there or just kind of knows better, that's probably the safer bet to go with. But anyways, so we are going to Micro Center. We're gonna hopefully get me a graphics card. Last night I actually played Borderlands 3 and I was getting like 20 frames on like super low settings, ultra low. David, what were you set at on your computer?
I was just running when it comes on default, which is just, I think it's just medium or whatever. But on medium I was getting like 95 frames.
So, yeah, we're gonna get me a better graphics card and hopefully my frames will be above 20. At work, I actually got picked out of a hat basically for having perfect attendance for a month. And when you get drawn for that, you win like $200, a gift card of $200, like a Visa card, which was really cool because I never win anything. And we don't really have like bonuses or anything at work, so I was pretty excited about that. So I'm just gonna use that and plus obviously other money that I've saved and give myself a graphics card. So I'm really, really excited. All right guys, so we just left Micro Center. We're gonna go up to GameStop. I'm gonna try to get like a little case for my Switch games because I desperately need one.
I would love laser legs so I don't ever have to shape them again.
So then you wouldn't be my Harambe anymore.
GameStop! Good news guys, I forgot Krispy Kreme existed, so guess where we are. David got his phone, guys.
Ooh. Are you excited?
Sasuke-kun!
I don't even know what just happened. Pardon the mess. So this is the graphics card that we got. The GeForce RTX 2060 Super. And it's RGB, so it's gonna light up really cool. So we got triple fans going on. RGB, it's gonna light up. It's pretty dope. I'm really excited. So we're gonna open this bad boy up. So it comes with just like the software and like a quick guide. That's super nice. I'm really excited. We're going to install it. I don't know that I'm gonna do like a time lapse or anything, but it's gonna go in my massive tower computer. In case you were wondering, this absolutely is a Pygmy Puff from Harry Potter. I got it from Universal Harry Potter. That is really loud. But I got my little Pygmy Puff at the Universal Harry Potter which is pretty dope. I super, super, super love Harry Potter. I super love Zelda. This is the map from Breath of the Wild. I actually play quite a bit of video games. I actually have a Twitch as well. So you would definitely head over to Twitch to check me out. I have recently been streaming Alice Madness Returns by American McGee, which is really awesome and amazing and a really, really incredible game. But we're gonna install this graphics card. So hopefully all of my gaming looks way better than it does currently and runs pretty good. All right, good news. We got the new graphics card in, it's all hooked up. And we just realized that it only has one HDMI plug. Super phenomenal. And the rest are display ports. So, all right, I know this video wasn't super long, but I really appreciate for you guys coming to hang out with David and I today. Make sure you like this video. Make sure you hit the big red subscribe button at the bottom. I post new videos every single Friday. We were posting them every Friday evening, but my awesome person that edits my videos and uploads them for me, Danielle, she started to upload them Friday morning, so you guys get them at the beginning of the day versus the end of the day, which is super, super nice of her. So I really appreciate that. So there will be a video next week. And I'm really excited about all the videos to come up. So I hope you guys really enjoy them. I've got a lot of stuff in my brain that I'm just excited to just get it on film for you guys to see it. So until next Friday, bye guys.